Hello and welcome back to my channel Accountancy Step by Step. I am an MCom postgraduate and I am teaching you accountancy with the help of my YouTube channel. So stay safe at home and study with me. Today we will learn about journal entries with the help of very easy.
And we have learned the rules of debit and credit for journal entries. So in this video, I am taking some more examples for journal entries. And these examples, I will show you with the help of very simple formulas. So first of all, let's revise this formula, which we have studied in the previous video also. The rules of accounting. These are actually the rules of debit and credit which we need to use while recording the financial transactions. So guys, we have studied accounting equation assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. So the rules which we apply for assets will be opposite for the rules for liabilities and capital. So just keep this thing into your mind. Assets plus expenses and losses. Expenses and losses we will add here just to remember the formula. And liabilities plus capital, we will include revenue and gains here, right? Okay, so here I have written if increases debit, if decreases credit. So just learn this formula for assets for making it more easy. What we can do, we can use this formula in short form, A plus E, and here I can write down L plus C plus R or G, anything, right? So for these two, the formula will be like this. If assets or expenses will increase debit, if assets or expenses will decrease credit, these will be opposite for in all the three scenarios. If liability, capital and revenue, if these will increase, we will credit it. So just opposite from this one. Okay, so just keep your eye on this one, keep this into your mind. A and D, if increases debit, if decreases credit. And these one will be reciprocal, right? Okay, and what about the golden rules? Golden rules of accountancy we will learn later in the accountancy book, but I have included here just to make the concept very clear to you. So golden rule says personal account, real account and nominal account has divided the accounts into three categories. Personal means related to any person. So think about that perspective. If related to any person, so that would be the receiver and or giver, right? So the golden rules of accountancy says debit the receiver and credit the giver for personal account. Real account basically is any asset related. For that, debit what comes in and credit what goes out. Nominal account, any expense related or income related. So the formula is, rule is debit all the expenses and losses and credit all the income and gains. So when you will do entry in on the initial stage, just keep these rules in front of you and then make the entries. Now I have collected some transactions to show you the practical how can we pass out these journal entries. Okay, so in the first slide, goods purchased on credit. If we are purchasing goods, then we will use the account purchase, goods purchased on credit. So here the word credit is here. Credit means creditors will be increased. We are not making the payment in cash. Goods purchased on credit for ₹30,000 from MS Govind Traders. Govind Traders will be our creditor. We have purchased some goods and we have not yet paid to the Govind Traders. So okay, so just have a look on this sheet what the rule is saying. A plus E. So goods purchased, goods will be our asset. So assets is increasing here, increasing debit. So what will we use? Purchase account debit. How much is the amount? 30,000. And this is the dual entry aspect. So another account which we will have to credit to make it equal both sides. MS Govind Traders. Govind Traders will be our creditors because we will have to pay Govind Traders back on 24th of December. So date is also given over here. Okay, so creditors, or we will write down the name of Govind Traders, but that will be our creditor. Creditor is our liability. So liability is also increasing, right? So if liability increasing, credit. So just have a look on this formula. We are applying only this formula right now, right? Only these rules we are using for this time to make the entries easy. So purchase account debit to Govind. Traders. Okay. And this amount we will write down here. For the format, you can go through. I'm not using all the details here. Here you'll have to write down the date, then the narration or the description. And LF column will also be here, ledger folio, which will show the page numbers. Here is the debit amount, here is the credit amount. This will be the format. Date we'll have to write down here. One more column you'll have to add. Okay, so just take care about that. So this is the first entry. Now the second one, office furniture is purchased. So furniture, again an asset is increasing, purchased from Modern Furnitures. So first of all, think about this. If furniture purchasing, so it means furniture is increasing. If furniture is increasing, then asset is increasing. So what will we write down? Furniture account debit. Okay, so furniture account debit. How much is the amount here? Let's go to our PPT. Amount is 25,000. We have purchased the furniture of 25,000. So in front of furniture, we will write down 25,000. In the debit column, because the asset is increasing, plus asset plus furniture. Furniture is an asset. Okay, so this is our PPT. And 5,000 paid by cash immediately. 5,000 cash if we have paid. So cash decreasing, right? And cash is an asset. If asset is decreasing, here cash is an asset decreasing, then credit. So to cash account, 5,000 rupees, and the remaining one. Now this is not balanced, so it's basically it's showing that some transaction or some entry is missing. So let's see what the entry is saying. And the balance of 20,000, it's still payable. If something is still payable, it means that will be our creditors. So creditors are there of 20,000. Creditor is the liability. If liability is increasing, as per this rule, if liability is increasing, then that would be credit. So the name is not mentioned over here. So what will we use? The creditors, right? Creditors account. And the 25,000 will be, okay. So Modern Furniture is our creditor. We have purchased the furniture from Modern Furniture. So what we should write over here is Modern Furniture. Modern Furniture's account will have to maintain while we will create our ledgers. Because in ledger, we'll have to create all the accounts separate. So this is the correct entry and the complete entry for this one. Okay, so this slide has been completed. Two entries are there, both are matching. So just apply this rule and we will do all the entries on this basis. Later on we'll use these also, or I'll tell you when we will have to apply these golden rules. Okay, so now let's go to the next slide. Okay, so first entry is business started with cash. So two accounts are involved here, cash and capital. If we are starting the business with cash, so the owner will introduce that amount. So that will be our capital from the business perspective. Capital and cash is introducing. So capital is our liability. Credit account will be this, liability increasing and cash is also increasing. So look at the formula. Cash is an asset, asset increasing, cash account debit, how much? 150,000 to capital is here. If something is introducing in the business, then just think about it, who will introduce it, right? So that will be the creditor, because obviously the owner will introduce it. Okay, so capital increasing. Next one, goods purchased from Manisha. Goods purchased, we are purchasing the goods, so introducing goods. Goods are an asset, stock is an asset, so goods increasing, debit. And for goods we use the account, purchases account, purchase account debit, how much? 36,000 to Manisha. They are not mentioned as of now that she has made the payment in cash or credit, so we are considering she has not yet made the payment. Okay, from Manisha, and Manisha is our creditor. Goods purchased from Manisha, we have purchased, so she is our creditor, we'll have to make the payment. So in case of creditor, creditors are increasing, then credit. So we will make payment of 36,000 later on. Stationery purchased for cash, stationery will also consider as an asset. Assets increasing, stationery account debit, cash will decrease. So asset decreasing also. Okay, so stationery account debit for increasing the asset. See here, increasing. Stationery account debit 2200 to, we have purchased it by spending cash. So cash is also an asset. So to cash 2200. Cash asset here is decreasing, here is increasing. Okay, so one debit and one is credit. Open a bank account. If we are opening a bank account, obviously one side cash will be affected. If I am going to open the account, bank account, bank and cash both are the assets. So here one bank account asset is increasing, bank account debit 35,000. And obviously I will open the account with the help of my cash. So to cash account, cash is also an asset. Asset decreasing here, right? So credit, cash account. Okay, now goods sold to Priya. We have sold the goods to Priya. So sales is here. Okay, Priya will be our debtors. If we are selling something, so either cash we will receive or debtors will increase. So here nowhere mentioned that she has made the payment in cash. So we are considering Priya as a debtor. Debtor is an asset, right? So Priya's account debit, asset increasing over here, 16,000 to sales. If we are selling something, then we will use the account sales. And goods are decreasing. Okay, 16,000 now received a check. Now this Priya has paid, which she has purchased or which goods we have sold, to Priya. Now Priya is making the payment, received a check. So bank account debit. If we are receiving check, then we will use the term bank. We are not getting the cash from anyone. 16,000 she has deposited directly to our bank, or we will deposit it in our bank. And to, from whom? To Priya. So debt is which earlier increased, now decreased, right? Priya has made the payment. We have received from Priya. To Priya, debtor's asset, now it is decreasing, so to credit. So just apply these only rules, only this one, first table, and do all the accounting entries as of now. These are very simple. Sold goods, again sales is here, to Nidhi. So we are selling the goods to Nidhi, so Nidhi's account debit, because nowhere mentioned that she has made the payment. Nidhi's account debit to sales, Nidhi will be our debtor as of now. Sales, then debtor will increase. Okay, if we are selling something, either we will receive the cash or we will increase our debtors to sales, because that person will have to pay us back. If we will receive something further from the customer, then that will be our debtor. In sale cases, debtors will increase. In purchase cases, creditors will increase. Okay, so Nidhi's account debit to sales. Sale, Nidhi pays. Now Nidhi has paid it. Nidhi pays 14,000 cash. So cash introduced in the business. Increasing cash. Cash is an asset. Cash account debit 14,000 from Nidhi. Nidhi has paid us. So Nidhi was our debtor. Now she has made the payment. Again, debtors is an asset. Asset decreasing here. So credit. Okay. So very simple entries by using those formulas. Now purchased goods. Goods introducing. Purchases account debit. Asset increasing as a purchase for 20,000 on credit. So first of all, write down, start this formula. Okay, asset increasing and goods is there. So what we will write? Purchase account debit. 20,000. Now we will see in which form we have made the payment. Either cash or we will pay it later. So if in case we will pay it later, then creditors will arise. In case we will have to make the payment now, then cash will decrease, right? So see, on credit we have purchased from Ritu. Ritu is the name of the creditor. In case of purchase, creditor will arise. So if creditor will increase, then liability, creditor is a liability increasing, so credit will have to do it. Credit to Ritu is the name of the supplier. 20,000. Okay, we have not yet made the payment to Ritu. Now insurance paid by check. If we are making the payment by check, insurance is an expense. Expense increasing, then expense account debit here. Insurance expenses. Okay. How much? 6,000. Two. Of course, we have made the payment by check. Check means bank or cash. So bank account debit to bank account. 6,000. Okay. Correct. Bank decreasing, asset decreasing, so credit. Next one, paid rent 2,000 rupees. We have made the payment of rent 2,000. So nothing is mentioned over here. It means this is obviously we have made the payment by cash. So cash is decreasing to cash, or made the payment of rent. Rent here is an expense. Anything which we are making the payment will consider as an expense, and expense increasing, so debit account debit to cash. Okay, amount is how much rent we have paid, 2000 rupees. Okay, now goods costing rupees 15,000 given as charity. Goods decreasing, asset decreasing, so to goods, or what will we write, to purchases. Which entry you will understand, which leg you can write down that one first. Now I am clear that purchases will be credit. Now 1500 and charity, so charity account we will credit debit over here. Okay, this is again an expense. Losses increasing, then debit. So charity is, of course, we are spreading anything, which we are giving something as a charity, then that will be our expense or loss. So in case they are increasing, then that would be debit to purchases account if we are using the goods. Purchased office furniture. Now furniture is an asset, office furniture increasing, furniture account debit. If any asset name is written over here, then we will use that asset name instead of purchase. If goods is mentioned over here, then we will, or purchase is mentioned over here, then we will use the account purchase account. For rupees 11,200. So if no creditor name written over here, then we'll have to consider it as a cash. We have purchased the furniture from cash. So furniture account debit 11,200, and the other asset is cash. Cash is also decreasing. So cash decreasing, credit 11,200. Both are the assets. One is increasing debit, one is decreasing credit. Next one is cash withdrawn. Cash withdrawn for household purposes. If we are withdrawing the cash for personal use or household purposes, that will be our drawing. And cash is will be reduced, right? So asset decreased, in case of asset decreased, credit. So again we can write this first to cash. $5,000 and drawings account we will debit over here. Okay, now see, drawing will be opposite of this. Like if capital introduced, capital increasing, we'll have to credit it. Drawings will have to deduct from the capital. Capital is something which has been introduced by the owner. Owner is introducing something for the business, and drawing, which owner is withdrawing. Okay, so this will be opposite. So if capital will be increased, then we will have to credit it. In case drawing will be increased, we'll have to make it debit. So this will be opposite from the capital. Next one is interest received. Now interest is an income. Income increasing, income received. Income is increasing, then that will be credit. Opposite rule, income is here, income or revenue. Increasing, credit, right? So you can check out both the legs and you will be very clear, right? By using only these simple formulas. What is this? Income. Interest received, I guess. Let me check. Interest received. Yes, interest received, cash 1200. So this is the income. Income increasing, credit 1200. And what else is here cash. Cash as an asset introducing. Cash is adding. Cash account. So cash will be debit. Cash account will be debited, right? Cash account debit to interest receipt. Next one is cash sales. Sales is always credit to sales. Sales is always credit, right? 2300. And now cash. We have sold something in return, introduced cash. So cash is an asset increasing as per this 2300 cash account. 2300. Okay. Commission paid. Now again, commission will be an expense. 3000 by check. Made the payment by check. So bank amount will be deducted. If check is here, then we will use bank. 3000. And if something is, you know, mentioned like commission paid, rent paid, salary paid, expense paid, so that will be our expenses or the losses considered like that. And in case increasing, of course increasing, commission we are paying or loss, so if that is increasing, that will be debit. Commission account debit. ₹3,000. Okay. Telephone bill paid. Again, telephone bill is an expense. So we are making the payment. So expense increasing ₹2,000. But bill written over here. Telephone bill account debit. How much is the amount? 2000. And we made the payment by using check. Check means to bank account. Okay. ₹2,000 will be deducted from our bank account. Payments of salaries in cash. So again, salary paid. Salary paid is an expense. Expense increasing. Debited. Salary account debit. ₹12,000 to cash. If check bill right over there, then we will use the word bank. Here cash is written over here, so we will use cash account. Okay, so all the entries are done now, guys. Just you also can take some more examples and just use this table as of now. Okay. These two are the golden rules. These are the golden rules, and learn this also. We will use this later. You also can use these formulas in these entries also. Both will be same. Application will be same and effect will also be same. So just learn these accountancy rules and this one also. As of now, I am using this because I feel very easy entries while I use this table. So just try to make a note in your mind directly. A plus E and LCR. Okay. LCR will be reciprocal from A plus E. And take a lot of illustration and try to resolve that. I will meet you in my next video. By the time, stay tuned. And yes, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also click on the bell icon. I will upload my next video quickly with a lot of different examples, different transactions, and we will cover up the journal entries. Okay. Also, one more thing, you also can follow my page, FP page, with the name of Accountancy Step by Step. Thank you so much for watching. See you in my next video. Bye bye. So please subscribe my channel Accountancy Step by Step. Also click on the bell icon to get the notification once I will upload more examples. Also follow my FB page with the same name of Accountancy Step by Step.